You're listening to Fountain of Thought with your hosts, Dennis Fountain and Sonny Rain. One small step for man, one giant leap for America.
This show contains adult themes and language. Listener discretion is advised.
Welcome, everyone, to the Fountain of Thought podcast. This is the podcast where we talk about anything and everything, just like a roller coaster with twists, turns, ups and downs, and maybe even a loop. Call in or leave us a voicemail on the listener line at 413-612-8037. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at TalkFOT, subscribe on YouTube and Rumble, or visit our website at fountainofthought.com. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I hear the squeakers, so as always, I would like to welcome my co-host and best friend and broadcast partner, Mr. Sonny Rain.
You know what I'm doing? I'm choking my chicken. Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
All right.
Oh, you been partying a little bit much, have you?
Oh, yeah, baby. We've been rocking it all week.
Rocking and rolling, twisting and turning, just like my roller coaster.
I got some new duds.
You got some new duds.
I got some new duds here.
That's nice.
This is my official Fountain of Thought Captain Meowser t-shirts.
Meow. Meow. Great. That's good. So do I dare ask, where are you celebrating New Year's?
In a hotel room. I just gave you a festive background so you could
set
the mood, you know,
to set the mood.
It's a new year. 2021 is done. I mean,
thank God.
I mean, it really wasn't anything to write home about, and
you can write.
I can say is three more years to go.
Yeah. Well, I would like to skip next year entirely. Let's just go to 2023. I don't see an end to this. And
I'm wearing these glasses in honor of 2021.
Oh, are you? Okay,
yeah,
good.
Yeah, I meant to point that out to you.
Okay, all right. Yeah. So today's topic, by the way, we've got a great show for you. It's a great show. The topic is somewhat saddening. We're going to talk about celebrity deaths in 2021. So, I mean, you know.
That's a great show.
Not going to have a party over that, but.
Boy, let me break out the champagne. We do have some fun things. I just start the show.
I know.
And
you just started.
And then you're just going to just piss all over it.
Just like that little guy in the back of a pickup truck that's pissing on the Chevy.
Here's to you,
Ford.
Mr. Robinson.
All right. So one of the things that's been bothering me is with this new variant of COVID, everyone's Omicron, and no one freaking knows how to pronounce it. So you and I are what? We're big Star Trek fans, correct?
That's right.
And how
we
many
boldly
times
go where no man has gone before?
And how many times have we heard Omicron in Star Trek? Right,
all the time.
All right. All the time. So I have put together every single time in Star Trek that they have said Omicron. So everyone out there will know how to pronounce it correctly. Here we go.
Omicron. Omicron. Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron. Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
Omicron.
So. Now, people, please pronounce it correctly.
Now, God. Is that the same thing as the Omicron variant of that they have out there? That's similar.
No, it's similar to OCP over in Detroit.
OCP.
Yeah, remember? You know,
OCP sounds like an old rap song from the 90s.
What police force was in Detroit?
Oh, the Omicron police force.
Yeah. Okay.
That's, yes, that's, folks, it's Omicron. Omicron. Yes. Omicron.
Omicron. Or O. I will accept both of them. Omicron, okay. Or Omicron. It's a Greek letter of the alphabet, people. It's been around for, yes, thousands of years, and you can't freaking
thousands
pronounce it.
Years.
I don't understand it.
Yeah, I can't understand it.
Don't understand. Okay.
I just don't understand.
I really don't. I don't understand. I just don't. I try. But, oh, yeah. Well, see, part of the problem I don't understand is you're really wired today, huh?
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir.
See, this is part of the problem.
It's worse than horrible because a zombie has no will of his own. You see them sometimes walking around blindly with dead eyes, following orders, not knowing what they do, not caring.
You mean like Democrats?
Yep.
That gets a big...
Ta-da! All right. So now we're going to settle in a little bit and...
get depressing.
Get depressing. Talk about those that have left us. And right off the bat, my children were devastated by this because they love Betty White. And Betty White has just passed. They joke around that Betty White is older than bread, but not anymore. So Betty White, 99. She died on December 31st, 16 days short of her 100th birthday.
Yeah, doesn't that suck?
Yeah,
I mean,
that's
really
bad.
Doesn't that suck?
I mean, go ahead.
And the worst part is, the People magazine with her on the front cover,
yeah,
hit the shelves just what a day or two beforehand.
Yeah. No, so
terrible.
We don't know what her cause of death was, and those of you that remember her probably remember her best for the Mary Tyler Moore Show, the Golden Girls in recent years, Hot in Cleveland. She won 8 Emmy Awards and a Grammy for a spoken word recording for her best-selling autobiography, If You Ask Me.
Excuse me one second.
Yeah.
I'm not claiming to be an expert or anything, but that doesn't look anything like Betty White.
Yeah, well, see, the photos are going every 30 seconds. So.
Oh, I see.
So that wasn't Betty White. Okay. So next on the list is Hank Aaron. He died at the age of 87 of natural causes on January 22nd. Hammer and Hank had a 21-season Major League Baseball career, most of the time with the Milwaukee and later Atlanta Braves. The Hall of Fame player hit 715 career home runs in 1974, breaking Babe Ruth's record for 33 years that he held. Aaron would end his
career.
I know.
Okay.
No, because
with all due respect, yep, and I love,
okay,
the man.
Here we go.
Great baseball player, but no. Babe Ruth will always be the home run king. Sorry.
Well, the difference that you're talking about is because of the length of games and the type of games that were played, and that you're getting into. Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
So. That's a subject for another day.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
So. Yeah, well, Hammer and Hank hit 755 home runs, a record that would hold until Barry Bonds surpassed it in 2007. And again,
Barry
yes,
Bonds
I know.
Never, he ever, paid... ever, ever surpassed anything because he was juiced up.
That's another reason I was going to get to that. So, yeah.
That's right. I said it. Said it right there. He was juiced up.
So, back on the Mary Tyler Moore days, we also had Lou Grant. Ed Asner died. He was 91 years old. He died on August 29th. No cause was given for his death. As I said, best known, he won an Emmy as Lou Grant on Mary Tyler Moore, went on later to have his own show called Lou Grant. One of his best performances, probably people today know him best as the character of Carl in the Pixar classic Up. Saw that movie? Did you see that movie?
Yeah, I saw that.
Okay. Lou Grant. Next on the list... I don't remember this guy, but I thought it was important to mention him. Peter Aykroyd, 66, died on November 20th. Again,
in relation to Dan?
Yes. Cause of death was unknown. He's his brother.
Wow.
Peter was a former cast member and writer for SNL. He joined the show in 1975 after being on SCTV. He received an Outstanding Writers Emmy nomination for SNL in 1980, and he had movie parts in Dr. Detroit and Dragnet. I don't remember him, and I'm sorry I don't, but I would have liked to, yeah.
Hey, just let me interrupt you for a second. Try
this. Yeah, anytime you want, interrupt.
Go like this, go. Maybe that'll help you enunciate now.
Enunciate?
Yeah, you're tripping over your words today.
Yeah.
You got my problem that I usually have.
Ned Beatty, 83, died of natural causes on June 13th. Beatty had a storied career that spanned the early 1970s to the mid-2000s. He had memorable roles in Network, which earned him an Oscar nomination. I like that movie. All the President's
Superman.
Men, Rudy, Toy Story
Superman.
3.
Superman.
He voiced Lotso, but his two most memorable films were The Deliverance and Superman. Lex Luthor's sidekick. Yes. And this gentleman that you see right now is Sonny Chiba, 82.
He was a badass.
He died. You know him. See, I did this for you because I didn't know you knew. Yeah. He died of pneumonia. He was a legendary Japanese actor. His real name is Shinichi Chiba. And he was best known for playing martial arts roles, Yakuza Cop, The Bullet Train, Quentin Tarantino's Kill Bill. Lots of other Japanese movies. He was a huge, huge Japanese star. So sad to see him go. Kevin Clark, only 32 years old, died on May 26th after being hit by a car while biking.
Ugh.
I know, huh?
Those are the worst. But people when it ends, like, that's awful.
Yeah, he's best known for being the brash drummer Freddie Spazzy McGee Jones in The School of Rock, starring opposite Jack Black.
Oh, yeah.
That's That's kind of sad. That's like, getting hit by the Jeep when you're working on it from Star Trek there.
Anton
Yelchin. Yeah.
Yelchin, rather. Yeah. Or Paul Walker, dying in an automobile accident right in the peak of your success.
I mean,
that's a hard one to swallow when it's,
Yeah. I mean, well, that's how
death is death, and it's terrible no matter when it happens, but when it happens at, natural causes or older age and because we all expect two things in life. We're going to pay taxes and we're going to die.
Yeah.
I'm avoiding either one.
That's how Robert Culp died. He was out jogging and fell and died.
Yeah.
It's just incredible.
Jim Fix, health guru of the world, died of a heart attack while jogging. Go figure.
Michael Constantine, 94, died on August 31st after a long illness. Best known for My Big Fat Greek Wedding. And if you go back to the 1970s, Room 222, and him and his wife were the one going around with the Windex spraying everybody. Yeah, Windex. This will take care of it. This will clear it up. Yeah. Screech died, unfortunately. Dustin Diamond, 44, died February 1st due to carcinoma. Best known for Screech and Saved by the Bell.
Yeah.
And never was fond of that show. And I was also never fond of DMX, but DMX died on April 9th. He was 50 years old. He had a heart attack. So I don't know.
Besides rap music, DMX did. He had a couple of decent movies.
He was in a couple of movies.
He starred opposite of Steven Seagal, and it'll come to me.
Yeah, he was. His real name is Earl Simmons, and he was nominated for a Grammy, although never won one. But yeah, DMX is no longer with us. And another one, which I'm very sad to see go, is Richard Donner, 91, died on July 5th. No cause of death. He's been a iconic director for The Twilight Zone. Back in the TV days, he's directed the episode with William Shatner, Nightmare at 20,000 Feet.
Lethal Weapon.
He did Superman, The Goonies, Lethal Weapon, The Omen, Scrooged, Maverick. Lots of movies. The guy was a good director, even though you do not like the Richard Donner cut of Superman. I do. No comment? I was waiting for a comment.
I was trying to place the movie we're talking about. Yeah. Oh no, I didn't. I don't like those recuts. I mean, once you see a movie and you fall in love with it, I don't like somebody going in and saying, "Well, you know what? Here's my version."
Except for
Justice League. That was the only one I did.
I was just gonna say that. That was really good.
When they did that one, that did it justice.
Robert Downey Sr., 85, died on July 7th.
Yeah, Iron Man's dad.
Parkinson's disease, yeah. He did Twilight Zone, Matlock, To Live and Die in L.A., Boogie Nights, Magnolia. And he made a 1970 movie called Pound, and both of his children, Allison and Robert, starred in that movie. Graham Edge, 80, died November 11th. No cause given. And Edge was the drummer of the Moody Blues Band. Moody Blues Band. They were okay. Not one of my favorites. Do you like Moody Blues?
Oh, yeah.
You did? Nah, wasn't. Yeah.
Knights in White Satin?
Well, they had a couple of songs that are good, but I just...
Sitting at the Wheel?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of them.
Not one of my favorites. Of course, one of my favorite is a publication producer, Larry Flint, died of heart failure on February 10th. He created Hustler magazine. Flint went on to become a First Amendment cult hero in his continued battles over regulations on pornography. The case would go on and become the basis for the 1996 movie The People vs. Larry Flint, which starred Woody Harrelson. He and his lawyer were shot by a gunman when they were in a courtroom fighting obscenity charges, and it left Flint paralyzed with permanent spinal cord damage. So he is no longer with us. Now, here's one. Do you know this guy? Can you see if you're watching?
I remember him from Stargate.
Exactly. Willie Garson, 57.
He was also in Sex of the City.
Yep. Died of pancreatic cancer September 21st. Like you said, Sex in the City. He was also in, he played Mozzie on USA Network's White Collar. Several episodes as Martin Lloyd in Stargate SG-1. Versatile actor, also starred in Little Manhattan, There's Something About Mary, and Groundhog Day. So that's sad. I liked him.
Yeah, he was good.
Also, another one that I liked was Charles Grodin. He died 86 years old on May 18th from bone marrow cancer. He became a comedy fixture in the 80s and 90s. He starred in The Great Muppet Caper, Midnight Run, which is a fantastic movie if you haven't seen that movie. Beethoven also did Dave, that the when he was an accountant for the president, which was good. That was another good movie he was in.
You liked, but you liked Midnight Run, didn't you?
I loved Midnight Run. That's one of my favorite movies.
It must
movies.
Really suck that Robert De Niro's in it, though, huh? for you now. Because he's right up there with Joe Buck now, isn't he?
I try to not pay attention to that, yeah, so... he earned an Emmy in 1977 for a Paul Simon special. He was a writer. Dusty Hill, 72, died July 28th, cause unknown.
ZZ
and he, of course,
Top.
Is correct. Yeah, a longtime member of the legendary rock band. He was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2004. And next we have Hal Holbrook, who was 95. He died January 23rd. Again, no cause given. He won a Tony in 1966 for one of his one-man stage shows, Mark Twain Tonight. I never saw it. He was also nominated for an Oscar in the 2007 Into the Wild. Never saw that one either. He starred in Wall Street, The Firm, All the President's Men. He played Deep Throat. But yeah, I those three movies, I don't remember those movies at all. I don't think I've ever seen them. Didn't
Hal Holbrook was in Deep Throat?
Yeah? No, he... No. Go away. No. No. This one, I brought into it, I don't know, but just because I dislike Alec Baldwin. Helena Hutchins, 42, died on the set of Rust when a prop gun fired by Alec Baldwin killed her. She was an up-and-coming director of photography. She had done movies Archemy, Snowbound, Darlin', Blind Fire, The Mad Hatter, and Rust. So
he did say he didn't pull the trigger.
He didn't pull the trigger. It just went off.
Just held the gun and it.
Guns
just
don't
went
kill
off.
People. No. Guns don't kill people.
People.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So
that's shot. What I heard. That's yeah. That's what I heard. That's the rumor. I'm not making any
judgments. I don't know. Shock G. Do you know who Shock G is?
No,
I didn't know either. I had no idea. I saw it. 57 died April 22nd in a hotel room from an overdose. Go ahead.
The only rapper on this list, I don't know if you'll get to him or not, but is Biz Markie. He also died this year.
I did not know. I didn't get that. That's the other thing I wanted to say about this list is it's not complete, trust me, but I did most of the famous celebrities that I could come up with.
But who you remember was... Biz Markie?
No. Who's
You got what I need, but you say you're just a friend. You don't remember Biz Markie?
Yeah, well, yeah. He was a Digital Underground, born Greg Jacobs, and he did the Humpty Dance. So, Larry King, 87, died.
Whoa!
The Humpty Dance, Digital Underground.
Is Marquee?
No, Shock G.
Oh, he produced it or he did it?
He sang it. He's the he was in the group Digital Underground. Shock G, born
he's
Greg
the actual
Jacobs.
Rapper from the
yes.
Oh, okay. Then I do know who he is.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. Yep. Gotcha. Yep. Now we're on the same page.
Yep. And Larry King, 87, died on January 23rd from sepsis and underlying conditions. Best known for the Larry King Live Show on that horrible network, CNN.
You
now this
like
guy,
CNN.
I hate CNN.
Oh come on, that's the greatest make believe.
Left.
It's a great make believe. You know, you want to
see good
some
fantasy
good
network.
Fantasies.
Yeah, good fantasy.
Good
fantasy.
Some good, you know, some really off the wall programming.
Yeah,
CNN. That's the place to go, dude.
Yeah,
you're missing out.
I know. I'm sorry. Yaphet Kotto, 81, died on March 15th. Again, no cause given.
Bad guy, live and let die.
I was just going to ask you if you could name what it was.
Start in Alien.
There
the
you
first
go. Yep.
Movie.
And Alien. He was also in Midnight Run. Yeah, he played the FBI. Wow, I'm having deja vu about this episode. But yeah, he was in Midnight Run where he was always wearing the sunglasses. Yeah, that was he was good. He was good.
Yeah, he's played a few roles where he plays like an FBI agent.
Yeah, he was in Homicide, Life on the Street. He did a couple other things, yeah. Art LaFleur, which is not a household name. I just keep thinking of him as the Tooth Fairy. But he has close to 170 credits. You might know him from The Sandlot. He was in The Incredible Hulk, Soap, Webster, The A-Team, Hill Street Blues, Cobra, Field of Dreams, Santa Claus 2, where he played the Tooth Fairy. Yep. He was in a lot. And then Tommy Lasorda, who I did not like, but am sad to see he's gone. 94, died of a heart attack. We know who Tommy Lasorda is, right?
I love LA Tommy Dodgers. Lasorda. What's wrong with Tommy Lasorda?
I never liked him. I think he was a loudmouth.
He's like Billy Martin and Ted, not Ted Knight, but the basketball coach.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, those are you know, flamboyant characters in professional sports. Yeah. Would you rather just sit there and just go like this and say, okay,
no,
next,
but I
next
just
batter up. Oh, guys, come on. Clap for the next batter, please.
Didn't like him.
Personality.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, go ahead.
Cloris Leachman, 94, died of natural causes on January 27th. Again, another one of the Mary Tyler Moore Show alum. They're going to be having a big party up in heaven because I think they're all there now. Malcolm in the Middle, he was also in High Anxiety and Young Frankenstein, both of Mel Brooks's great works. And she won an Oscar for her performance as a timid school teacher in The Last Picture Show. So she also won 8 Emmys. So, Cloris Leachman.
What if you die of unnatural causes? What is that?
Murder. COVID.
That's unnatural?
COVID's not natural. If you have a disease of something, then yeah, that's unnatural.
That's unnatural.
Natural is most likely you just died of old age. You fall asleep. You die
but
in your sleep.
But according to China, COVID comes from nature. So yeah. would that be natural?
Those damn bats. Yeah. Those damn bats. Rush Limbaugh, 70, died February 17th from lung cancer, which was a shame because he always used to say his former nicotine-stained hands, he had stopped smoking for, I think, 20-plus years, but it did get the best of him. In 2020, President Trump awarded him with the highest civilian honor, the Medal of Freedom, Presidential Medal of Freedom. So, Rush. Jackie Mason, 93, died on July 24th after being hospitalized, no cause given. Known for mixing Jewish themes and political incorrectness, Jackie Mason became a fixture in the stand-up comedy scene for decades, and he was also featured in 1988's comedy
Caddyshack 2.
There you go. Good boy. Now, one of our favorite, Norm MacDonald, very, very sad to see him go. 61, died on September 14th from cancer. Norm is best known for Dirty Work, Billy Madsen, Dr. Doolittle, on TV as SNL, Norm, The Orville.
And the best damn Burt Reynolds impersonation you ever wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Oh. Turd Ferguson.
Turd Ferguson. Yeah.
Sportos and Motorhead.
Whoop, yep. Next, John Madden, 85, died on December 28th, no cause given. Madden was a Super Bowl-winning NFL coach and commentator. He ran the Oakland Raiders back in 1971, giving them a Super Bowl victory. This is Helen McCrory, 52, died of cancer on April 16th. She's best known for playing Narcissa Malfoy in the 3 Harry Potter films. She was also in a movie called The Queen and James Bond's 2012 movie,
2012 movie?
Mm-hmm. Skyfall.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, you're Mr. James Bond.
I am Mr. James Bond until you get to Daniel Craig.
To the later ones, yeah.
And then, I mean, yeah. I've watched them, and some of them, yeah. They're okay, but I don't know. Yeah. They're just not me.
Yeah. Eddie Mecca, 69, died on November 17th. The Big Ragu, Carmine Ragusa.
You'll never go from rags to riches.
Yeah, from Laverne and Shirley. He starred in over 50 TV shows, and he earned a Tony Award nomination for playing the 1975 Broadway musical, The Lieutenant. Michael Nesmith, 78, died of natural causes on December 10th. Guitarist for the 60s pop band.
The Monkees. Jimmy Dolenz is now, he's the last one left.
Yeah. Yeah. Band was created at the height of the Beatles' popularity, NBC's answer to the Beatles. The Monkees show was a number one hit for NBC. Davy Jones, Peter Tork, and Mickey Dolenz did silly comedy, performing chart-topping songs. Over the career, Nesmith won a Grammy and was an executive producer behind the 1984 cult classic movie Repo Man, which I did not know until I researched this. Repo Man. I like that movie. That was a good movie. Christopher Plummer, 91, died on February 5th. No cause given. He received 2 Tony Awards, 2 Emmys, Best Supporting Actor Oscar for his performance in the 2010 drama The Beginners at the age of 82, making him the oldest person ever to win an Academy Award. He had a slew of memorable roles, including The Insider, Knives Out, and Captain Von Trapp in the 1965
Klingon
movie The Sound of Music. But you're right, I think his most memorable role is General Chang in Star Trek VI. The Undiscovered Country. Tanya Roberts, 65, died on January 4th due to complications from a urinary tract infection. I didn't know you could die from a UTI. What is she best known for?
Bond Girl.
There you go. Which movie?
View to a Kill.
View to a Kill. Good job. There you go. Yeah. She was also one of Charlie's Angels in Charlie's Angels. She was Julie Rogers. And she played Midge in that 70s show. She's also known for playing across Mark Singer in The Beastmaster.
Oh, yeah. That was a good movie. I like that. That was really
good. And for appearing in Playboy. It's pretty good when you're known for appearing in Playboy. Yeah. Peter Scolari, 66, died of cancer on October 22nd. He's probably best known for Bosom Buddies, starring opposite Tom Hanks, and working on the HBO series Girls. He was also an Emmy nominated for the comedy series Newhart. Phil Spector, known in the music world, died of natural causes on January 6th. He was 81 years old. He was a music producer, worked for everyone from the Beatles to the Ronettes. Spector was known later in life for being convicted of murder. And in 2009, he was sentenced to 19 years to life in prison for murdering actress Lana Clarkson in 2003.
Was he related to Ronnie Spector?
I don't know. That I don't
know. The singer?
I don't know.
I wonder if that was his wife.
I don't know. And this is probably the saddest, one of the saddest people on the list. Dean Stockwell, 85, died at home of natural causes on November 7th.
Favorite shows, yeah.
Yeah. Stockwell is best known for playing Admiral Al Calavici in the TV series Quantum Leap in the early 90s. He had a slew of memorable roles on the small and big screen. He played Brother Cavill in the early 2000 revival of Battlestar Galactica. Director David Lynch cast him in the 1984 adaptation of Dune. He was in Blue Velvet. He was in Roy Orbison's In Dreams. Stockwell formed a respectable character and had a great filmography, including To Live and Die in L.A., Beverly Hills Cop 2, and Married to the Mob. And he won a Oscar for Best Supporting Actor. Dave Thomas, 70, died August 7th of natural causes. Thomas founded Kool & the Gang in 1964 alongside several of his teenage friends, including brothers Robert Kool, Ronald Kalis, Robert Spike, and Charles Smith, George Brown, and Ricky West. Kool & the Gang is now extra cool. Another musician, Charlie Watts, 80, died on August 21st, no cause given. For nearly 60 years, Watts was the drummer for the Rolling Stones. He was the third longest-running Rolling Stones member behind Jagger and Richards. His last concert with the band took place in Miami on August 30th, 2019. Cicely Tyson, She was 96 years old. She died January 28th. Cause of death was not announced. In a career that spanned more than 70 years, Tyson made her mark in every form of entertainment medium, having won 3 Emmys, a Tony, an Oscar, and a Peabody. She was most known for her Oscar-nominated performance in the 1972 drama Sounder, her Emmy-winning role as Ophelia Harkness in How to Get Away with Murder, and her countless stage performances. And there's Charlie Watts. Next on the list, unfortunately, is Clarence William III. Remember him? Do you remember who he is? No. Clarence Williams III. He died on June 4th from colon cancer. After wowing audiences on the Broadway stage in the mid-60s and earning a Tony nomination, Clarence Williams III found the mainstream stardom playing Link Hayes in the TV series The Mod Squad, which ran from 68 to 73. Williams's memorable roles included playing Prince Abuse's father in Purple Rain, Mr. Sims in 1995.
Yes. Now I know who you're talking about. Yeah.
He was also in the movie cult film Half-Baked. He played alongside Dave Chappelle. Sam Wright, 74, died on May 24th after a 3-year battle with prostate cancer. A 2-time Emmy Award-nominated actor did everything from playing Dizzy Gillespie in Clint Eastwood's 1988 Bird to being the Purple Grapes character in the series Fruit of the Loom underwear commercials, but he will probably be best remembered as the voice of Sebastian the Crab in the Disney classic The Little Mermaid. Jeff Labor, 58, died on July 11th, undisclosed reasons. He was a longtime guitarist and glam metal band for Cinderella. Gavin McLeod, the old Captain Steubing, died on May 29th. No cause given. He was 90. Love Boat star Gavin McLeod played Captain Steubing in the famed series, also on The Mary Tyler Moore Show and McHale's Navy.
Yep.
We're just about done here, wrapping it up. We've got B.J. Thomas, 78, died from lung cancer. Won a Grammy.
Drops keep falling on my head.
That doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me. No, I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining. Yeah, I don't sing. Lloyd Price, 88, died on May 10th from diabetes. Lloyd Price was an early rock and roll star and singer, songwriter, best known for such hits as Lottie Miss Clottie, Personality, and Stagger Lee. Tawny Kitaen, you remember Tawny?
Yeah, cartwheels over the Mercedes-Benz. How can you ever forget it?
Yeah. 58. Only 58. God, died on May 7th. No cause given.
She was also opposite of Tom Hanks in the movie Bachelor Party.
Correct. 1984's Bachelor Party. She did numerous music videos, including White Snakes, Is This Love, and Here I Go Again.
She was married to David Coverdale, wasn't she? The lead singer of White Snake.
Oh, possibly.
My memory serves me correctly.
My research did not turn that up, but that is a possibility. Olympia Dukakis, 89, died on May 1st, no cause given. Olympia is Hollywood's favorite late bloomer, best known for her Oscar-winning turn in 1987's movie Moonstruck, and for being whose cousin?
Who?
Whose cousin? What is she famous for? Being whose cousin?
Who?
Olympia Dukakis.
Yeah, what about her?
Who's her cousin?
How the hell do I know who her cousin is?
Really? What state did you live in?
I try to forget that man. Stop bringing him up.
Massachusetts Governor Michael Dukakis.
And what happens? You bring that name up, and all I can think of is that stupid helmet? Army helmet on the tank that was 3 times too big for his head.
It's worse than horrible because a zombie has no will of his own. You see them sometimes walking around blindly with dead eyes, following orders, not knowing what they do, not caring.
You mean like Democrats?
Yeah, just like that.
Yeah. George Segal, 87, died on March 23rd following complications from a bypass surgery. Oscar-nominated actor George was last seen in ABC's The Goldbergs. And this one you probably don't remember because I don't think you were a fan of the show, but Mira Furlan, 65, died on January 20th from West Nile virus. Who knew you could die from that? Get bit by a mosquito and die?
Yeah.
that's, I mean, I know they carry malaria and things like that, but West Nile?
Yeah.
Wow, that's unlucky. Excuse me. She played Danielle Russo on TV's Lost and Delenn on Babylon 5. That's what I know her best from, Babylon 5. And the last person I have on my list, and like I said, there are others, but the last person I have is Siegfried Fischbacher. Do you know who Siegfried is?
From Sigmund and Freud.
Freud? Siegfried and Freud?
Freud's other half.
Siegfried and Roy?
Freud.
He was 81 and he died of pancreatic cancer. He was one and a half of that famed magic act, Siegfried and Roy. I did not. Was he the one that got mauled by the tiger, or was that Roy? Was that the other guy? I think it was him, right? Wasn't he the one that got mauled?
I don't remember.
Yeah, no. I think that was him. Yeah.
You should know this. You're a big Vegas person.
I know, but I don't. So. I apologize. That is my list of those that have passed. And do you have anyone that I might have missed?
I had 12 of them written down, and you covered all of them, I believe. It's a lot of people this year.
Yeah. What I was surprised is I believe there were on the list that I had only two people that died from COVID. There were very few COVID deaths on there, and they lead you to believe that people are dropping left and right from COVID. But I know it's serious. I'm not saying it's not, but I'm not going to get into a whole philosophical conversation over it. But I had expected to see much more people on that list that died from COVID than what had happened. But they will be missed. It's tough because, you watch these people every week or in movies all the time. They come into your homes and they're kind of a part of your life. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. They're a part of your life. You watch shows faithfully over and over a year. And if they've been on 5 years, 8 years, 10 years, some of these shows, and you're just accustomed to them being a part of you. And if you've watched them long enough, you see them age and grow and move on, and it feels like they're a part of you. And that's part of what it is being a celebrity. Anyways, they will be missed. Rest in peace, all of them. And hopefully they will live in peace, and people will have great memories of them like we do. So,
yeah, agreed.
Yeah. All right. Anything else to add here, big guy?
No.
Did I depress you enough?
Well, it's not the happiest subject in the world, but like I said before, it's part of life.
Well, I think it's necessary to do. We do this every year on the podcast, and I think it's something to do, again, not to be solemn, but to be joyous in the works that they've done, and to appreciate the movies and the songs and everything that they've done, because especially for me and for you, TV and movies are a huge part of my life, and music, they're giant. Those are three big things in my life, And I look forward to losing myself in movies and TV and in music and stuff, and it's gonna be sad missing some of those people. So
yeah, and one added thing, yesterday we already had one of our first major deaths happened yesterday.
Who died?
And that
yesterday?
Was Antonio Brown's career. You see it? It went up in flames, right down in the meadowlands of New York. It was gone.
All right, that's going to wrap it up for this segment. We're going to be right back after I watch the dyslexic version of Bitty Bitty Chang Chang.
Hi, we're the Goo Goo Dolls. We're fortunate that our daughters have what they need to grow and learn. But that isn't the case for nearly 13 million kids in the U.S. that struggle with hunger.
Childhood hunger is a heartbreaking reality that Feeding America is working to change. Each year, the Feeding America network of food banks rescues billions of pounds of good food that would have gone to waste and provides it to families and children in need.
You can help kids in need in your community by visiting feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Fountain of Thought podcast, listen you will. Funny they are. Talk about anything and everything they do. wit and charm DJs Dennis and Sonny have. Fountainofthought.com, website you go. There is no try, only do.
Welcome back. If you are interested in becoming a sponsor of this show or advertising, drop us an email at talkfot@gmail.com or give us a call at 413-612-8037.
Listen, so, you're being rude. You're fake news. You're fake news. Stop being rude. You're fake news.
No, it's not fake news. It's...
The moment you've been waiting for is finally here.
Yes,
true or false headlines.
All right, true or false headlines, sponsored by the Ludlow Lions Club. Do you want to help those in need in your neighborhood? Volunteer to help today. You can learn more by visiting their Facebook page or by visiting ludlowlions.org or by calling 754-900-ROAR. All right, this is pretty simple and straightforward. I'm going to give you two headlines. One is true and one is false, and Sonny's going to show us his ability to be smart.
First of all, I want to thank you very much.
For?
For not pointing out that I have a Band-Aid on my nose. Because I got a big honking zit.
Okay.
I just, before somebody was, you know, started to question it, I wanted to point that out.
I that hadn't even noticed it.
You know, you're such a good friend.
Nor do I notice the mess behind you.
Do you want to see the big honking zit?
No, I don't. No, right. I don't. No.
I'll take pictures and send them to you later.
All right, thanks.
All right, let's go. Let's do
okay.
this. Come on.
So, one is true, one is false. Florida man. Yep. Florida man pulled over and detained for driving with his penis. Or Florida man with drugs around his penis denies they were his.
Well, first and foremost, your first headline, that actually happened on a trip to New York City back when I was in high school. I was in high school. And we were downtown New York. And a Mercedes-Benz pulled up next to the school bus and started, woohoo!
Driving with his penis?
True story. And one person saw it. The one person that saw it was a very, very shy girl. You couldn't, if she said three words in a day, you were lucky. She spots it, turns red, can't speak. Person next to him looks down, sees it. Next thing you know, the whole bus pushes over to the left-hand side and it's tilting.
Shut up.
I swear to God. And I don't swear to God unless I mean it. That's
who else was on that bus? I want corroboration. Who else was on that bus?
I'm not going to name names right here on the air, but I will give you a list.
Okay.
It was the funniest, damnedest thing. Anyway.
Well, then.
Back to your, what?
Maybe that's the true one then.
No, it isn't. It's the other one. It's the man with the drugs around his. I read that.
Oh, you are correct.
I said, that guy is clever. Real clever. Oh, that's not mine. How the hell did they get there?
Florida authorities said they found cocaine and meth wrapped around a man's penis during a traffic stop, but the man denied the drugs were his. Boy, I guess he really had a hard time. Brum-bum. Brum-bum. Brum-bum.
Wait, there it is.
See, we need... Pinellas County Sheriff's deputies said they stopped a vehicle driving without its lights on at 4 a.m. We'll see, the penis wasn't long enough to reach the switch. WFLA-TV reports the driver was arrested on charges of DUI and marijuana possession. Authorities said they found a gun under the passenger seat while searching the car and discovered the drugs while searching the passenger. The man said the drugs were not his, but he did not say who the drugs belonged to, according to the arrest record.
So. That is such fake news. You're fake news.
All right. Here is the next one. Drunk driver calls 911 on themselves, or drunk driver calls 911 on the police.
That's interesting, because I think that the guy back in New York City that was in that car below the bus was arrested for drunk driving.
Did that he call 911?
And yes, but that part I can't.
Well, 911 wasn't around back then.
I suspect. 911 wasn't back in the 80s?
No.
Really?
911 is a newer thing, yeah.
I think you're crazy.
No, I'm not. I can tell you.
You'll have to prove that. You're going to have to prove that one to me.
I can tell you exactly. Anyway. Because it helps if I spell it right. When was 911 invented? Now it's going to come back. Oh, in 1935. Yeah, 1968. But I don't think we had 911 around here.
Because we did.
I don't think so. Did they have 911?
So those touchstone phones came out.
AT&T brought it in the 1970s. Emergency line throughout all 50 states by 1970. So maybe it was. Maybe you are correct, and I'm incorrect. So, I mean,
as far as your headlines go,
yeah,
it's the one who called the drunk driving on the police.
Okay, you are incorrect. I'm sorry.
I am not incorrect.
You are incorrect because I actually have the call. Are you ready for this one?
Listen, you're fake news. You're fake news.
No, I am not fake news. Here is the actual phone call.
Clark County 911.
Somebody's really drunk driving down Granton Road.
Which way are they going?
They are going
towards Granton or towards Galesville?
Towards Granton.
Okay, are you behind them or?
No, I am them.
You am them?
Yes, I am them.
Okay, so you want to call and report that you're driving drunk?
Yes.
Okay, what's your name?
Mary.
Okay, hold on 1 second, Mary, okay?
Okay.
Are you still driving right now?
Yes.
Do you want to stop driving before you get in an accident?
Yes, I will stop.
Okay, you going to stop right now?
Yep, I will stop right now.
Okay, just hold on a second, okay?
Okay, I'm stopping.
Okay, just hang on the phone, okay?
So, did you ever call 911 on yourself?
Oh, no, I can't say that I did.
Oh, boy,
besides, I've told you before, I was number one for, I don't even like driving sober, never mind driving drunk.
Or you
like
were better.
In the back seat so I could be the bartender.
You were a better driver with a buzz on.
You think so?
Yeah, you were. You were a much better driver. Yeah.
I don't remember.
Welcome to Name That Theme, where your lovable hosts, Dennis and Sonny, try to impress you with their knowledge of theme songs. Who can name that theme song the quickest? Let's find out!
All right, Sonny and I will each pick a contestant to play for, and then volley 4 theme songs at each other. We'll each be allowed 1 pass. Points are awarded for the fastest response time. The faster your answer, the better you score. Each week, the winning contestant's name will be entered into our monthly $25 gift card giveaway. If you want to win, you got to register at fountainofthought.com. All right.
When did you make that charming intro?
We had that last time we played this.
I didn't. Yeah. It must have been so impressive to me last time I didn't notice.
That's the actual theme of Name That Tune.
Ooh.
All right. You are playing for John Ribber, R-I-B-E-R, or maybe it's Ryber. Actually, that would be John Ryber. You are playing for John Ryber. And I am playing for, that came out really good, Elaine Fanley. Okay, who's going first?
I will let you go first this week.
You'll let me go first?
What's the category?
Oh, Sonny picked the category, and the category
Why did Sonny pick the category?
Because he won. The winner picks the category.
When did he win? Last week? The week before that?
He's won every week. Yeah, so he picks all of the categories because he's the big winner. Yeah, he's the winner. He picked comedy movies, and there can't be any words in the theme. It has to be all instrumental.
So, shh.
God. Here is your first theme song. Okay, wait. I gotta wait till the little seconds because I have to time this. So I gotta wait till the seconds roll around, and I I give you the proper time. So you've got 15 seconds to kill here. Now you've got 10 seconds to kill. And you got a countdown of 10 seconds. Are you ready? Leave the zit alone. And on the count of you go. And here it is. Sorry, that was 30 seconds.
I'm going to execute my pass right
away. You're going
right
to pass. That was one of my favorite movies, A Fish Called Wanda.
Oh.
So Sonny passes on his very first one. Ooh, might I have you stumped this time? Okay. Actually, the rest are all very easy. So here you go. Here is your, technically, your first one.
Caveman.
Very good. Very, very good. You got that in 10 seconds. Caveman. So that gives you a score of 10. 10. All right.
Okay, you ready for your first one?
No, but go ahead. Stripes. 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 Hello. Stripes.
I heard you.
Okay.
Just be patient. Be patient.
See, we really need producers. How fast did I get
one.
That?
You got one. Look at that. You got one.
How fast was that? Did I beat you?
9 seconds.
9 seconds. Woo. Okay. Here is your next one. Go.
Airplane 2.
Oh, dang it. Oh, 24 seconds. I thought you would say Battlestar Galactica.
You're rigging it by putting these long intros in till it gets to the meat of the song.
What do you want me to tell? I couldn't go to the meat of the song on that one because you would have said Battlestar Galactica, and that would have been wrong.
Well, no, I wouldn't. I would be smart enough to know that the Battlestar Galactica is not a comedy movie.
Yeah, but that's fine. You know what? I edited another one for you to make it easier, and I shouldn't have. So,
you ready for yours?
Yeah, go ahead.
Which one do I want to do? Which one do I want to do? Which one do I want to do?
Oh God, Ghostbusters!
Wow, 5 seconds. Look at that.
All right. Ready? And go.
Get smart.
Get Smart is correct, and 20 seconds.
Another one with a huge introduction.
Hey.
Well, I'll know better next time. To make sure no editing on my behalf.
Go ahead. Give me the next one.
Maybe I can get some with them actually tuning their instruments before they start playing. Get that clock really stirring.
Hey, you should know these better.
Yeah,
I'm going to pass. I have no clue. What was that?
You're going to pass on Gremlins?
Oh, see, now it comes.
Now it comes to me. Back. Yep. Yep.
Okay, Gremlins. Here's your next one.
Yep. Yeah, talk about long intros. Ladybugs. School of Rock. Ladybugs. What was that other, what's his name one? School of something or another.
Wow. You got it wrong.
What is it?
Yeah, I got it wrong.
What was it?
Come on, John Belushi's most famous role.
Is that Animal House?
That's Animal House.
I knew it had some school. It was a school thing of it.
It's a Faber College theme.
All right.
You had a big
30 seconds for me. So right now you are losing by 10 seconds.
Well, make sure you put something with a long-ass intro on.
I'll have you know that I edited this one for you to make it easier. I got rid of some of the beginning part to make it easier for you. So I don't want no shit from you. All right. Ready? Yeah, hold on, wait for the clock, and I need 5 more seconds, because I don't like doing math, so I like it when it's a round number. Here you go.
Airplane.
You suck!
What, did you think I was going to say Jaws?
I did. I thought you would say Jaws.
It's that comedy Jaws!
Shut up. 58 seconds.
Here's what I got. I had one for you, too. Listen to this one.
Buck Rogers? Is that Buck Rogers?
Oh, you're such an idiot.
What is it?
It's the same movie. It's just it's after Jaws.
After. So four. I have to get this in 13 seconds or you win. It doesn't look good for me. Go ahead. Eddie Murphy. Damn it, I missed the second. Beverly Hills Cop 2.
You're wrong. You're wrong.
Beverly
you're
Hills
wrong,
Cop
wrong,
1.
Wrong, wrong, we're wrong, wrong.
Beverly
wrong,
Hills Cop wrong. 3. I know it's not the first one. What is it? It's not Beverly Hills Cop?
No, it's Fletch.
Oh, that's right. They ripped it off.
Yes. They Harold Faltermeyer.
Yeah. All right. Just for
who won again?
Who?
Who?
Who? 34-674. You won 50-67 by 24 seconds.
Okay.
You won by 24
seconds.
What's
your last one? You want to play my last one for me just for us?
That was 4. You made a pass. I played 5. Yeah, that was.
It's all of them?
Yeah, that's all of them. How much more do you want?
Have you seen my wiener?
No, I have not, and I'm not going to get into that, actually. I'm just going to let that one slide because I'm just not going there. Okay.
You're in big trouble, though, pal. I eat pieces of shit like you for breakfast.
You eat pieces of shit for breakfast?
It's time to dig deep. That only means one thing. It's time for questions. From my side.
Being sponsored by Cobbler's Corner on the corner of Arkansas and Bowen in Pantego, Texas, where you're going to find expert craftsmanship at unbeatable prices. Tell them you heard this ad and receive a 20% discount off of any repair. Give them a call at 817-460-0600. Well, they'll save your soul and gladly die for you.
Die for you.
Die for you. All right, shut up. These are questions that the listeners or viewers send in, and I put them in my big sack, and I reach into my sack, and I pull them out of my sack. And the first question is, this person needs better penmanship. Did you ever cut your hair as a child and mess it up? Did you ever cut your hair as a child and mess it up?
Never.
I never cut my hair as a child. However, as an adult, I did cut my hair one time. And it was back in the 90s. And I was a clown, Honkers the Clown, playing Honkers the Clown for a Lions function. And I had one of those rainbow wigs to put on. And I couldn't get it on because my hair was too much, too thick. So I said, I'm going to cut a little bit off. And you know how that works. You cut a little bit, and cut a little bit, and cut a little bit. You keep cutting.
Is that when you started shaving your head?
And that is exactly when I started shaving my head. Oh, that's when that started. Yeah. And from then on, I shaved my head for, I don't know, 15, 16 years or so. One of my kids never even saw me. When they saw me with hair, they were like, ah, my God, you have hair. Yeah. So, all right. Next one is.
That reminds me of.
Have you seen my wiener?
Shut up. That doesn't remind you of that. No. No. What that reminds you of is.
DuPont was using drugs and would walk around with a machine gun.
He did. He did. He did have that damn machine gun.
John DuPont is behind bars tonight, charged with murder. John DuPont is an heir to the fortune of one of America's wealthiest families. Police say he's also a suspected murderer.
Never gets old. Never gets old. Next question is, if they made an action figure out of you, what accessory would it come with? So that's an accessory, not, you know, part of you, an accessory.
An accessory on an action figure of me?
Yes.
Easy. You just push the belly and.
Well, that's not an accessory.
So that's an accessory, baby.
You might have to have one of those squeezy things.
That is an accessory.
That's an accessory?
Yes.
All right. Mine would either come with a miniaturized dog or a Camaro. I don't know which.
Oh, God.
Good.
Oh, God. I'm so in love with that car.
I am in love with that car.
It's just you and that car.
Yep. I'm going to be buried in it. All right. Last question is, what is your favorite birthday? What is your favorite birthday?
You mean when was my favorite birthday? What age?
It says what is. So I don't know. You interpret that any way you would like.
What is your favorite? That doesn't even make sense. What is your favorite
birthday? I don't write them. I just read them.
I'll answer it just the way it's written. What is your favorite birthday? The next one.
My favorite birthday is cake.
Is cake?
Birthday cake. Get it? What is your favorite birthday? Birthday cake.
I don't get it.
What is your favorite birthday? Birthday cake. Never mind.
Of the week.
What you got for us this week, big guy?
Let's talk about...
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk. Oh, I'm sorry.
Is this going to turn into a musical every week with you? New Year's resolutions.
Yeah, I think so.
How's your head?
I haven't had any complaints yet.
Have you seen my wiener?
New Year's resolutions. New Year's resolutions. Every year, you're going to listen to all this bullshit from people. Well, that's it. Come from January 1st, I'm going to lose weight. I'm going to quit smoking. I'm going to quit drinking. Yeah, sure you are. Sure you are. You all year long, you've been a complete fuck up. But yeah, come New Year's Eve when that ball drops, you're going to do all these amazing things. You know what you're going to do? You're going to clog up the gyms for the first week. If you make it two or three times, preventing the people who normally go on a regular basis having to wait for machines and weights and so forth and so on. You're going to walk around in a miserable, rotten attitude because you're trying to get rid of one of your vices. Come on, people. It's a big crock of shit. Resolutions, make them simple. Like, I don't know. I make a resolution that when I drive, I'm not going to be an asshole behind the wheel. I'll respect other drivers. Or... I'll put more in the collection basket when it goes around church. I don't know. Make it simple. Don't make it earth shattering. And that is my pet peeve.
Your pet peeve of the year. Ooh. Oh, the pressure.
That and.
Have you seen my wiener?
All right. Any final thoughts?
Final thought. No, not really.
All right. Leave your opinion and your thoughts on our listener line at 413-612-8037. Thank you, everyone, really, for listening in, and we do appreciate it. Reminding you, if you would like, you can subscribe to our podcast via your listening or viewing preference. And don't forget to visit our website at fountainof.com. And remember, everyone...
Wait.
What?
Mom, yeah? The meatloaf! Fuck!
Language, language! And remember, everyone, be a fountain...
Not a drain.
Goodbye, everyone. See you next week.
Sportos, motorheads, geeks, sluts, bloods, wastoids, dweebies, dickheads. They all adore him. They think he's a righteous dude.
I'll take Letitch now for 800.
That's Let It Snow.
Whatever.
DuPont was using drugs and would walk around with a machine gun.
Give that off, folks.
The number you have reached, 911, has been changed to a non-published number.